Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to today's Sunday School. I'm so glad you could join us today. Let me hope that you guys are doing very well and that you're staying safe at home. Today, you're going to listen to an exciting Bible story. It's called Gideon Lead God's Army. And the focus of our lesson is God helps us obey him. Our Bible memory is from Deuteronomy 6, verse 18. And our Bible memory says, "And thou shalt do that which is right and good in the sight of the Lord, that it may be well with thee, and that thou mayest go in and possess the good land which the Lord sware unto thy fathers." Let's repeat our Bible memory again, boys and girls. Deuteronomy 6, verse 18. "And thou shalt do that which is right and good in the sight of the Lord, that it may be well with thee, and that thou mayest go in and possess the good land which the Lord sware unto thy fathers." Boys and girls, today we're going to learn about a man named Gideon. Now, Gideon and his army quietly walk up to their enemies while they were camping. Okay, so you will learn that Gideon had an army and he and his army quietly walked up to their enemies while they were camping. What do you know about camping, boys and girls? Have you ever gone camping? What do people do when they go camping? Look at this picture right here. This is a family and they're at a campsite. Look at the picture. What do you see is happening here? Talk to someone. What is happening? Yes. As you can see, they're a group of children with their parents, and they're cooking over a campfire. There seem to be roasting marshmallows or something over a campfire there, okay? Look at the father. What is he doing? He's playing music with his guitar, okay? So people normally do lots of different things when they go camping. They cook food over a campfire, they play board games, they play music and dance. They have a wonderful time, okay? So this family here is having a wonderful time at their campsite. But in today's Bible story, you're gonna learn about an army. And they were camping beside a stream, okay? So this group of men were camping beside a stream. All right, so let's get to our Bible story. Listen up carefully now. The people of Israel had forgotten to obey God. Now, the people of Midian were ruling over the Israelites. And the Israelites, they didn't like that. And they prayed and asked God to help them. Now, God chose a man named Gideon to help the Israelites. So here is Gideon. And God chose him to help the Israelites. What do you think he's going to help the Israelites to do? Okay, let's find out. Now, so here are the group of men. They were camping, all right? So Gideon was the leader of the group of Israelites. But Gideon blew a trumpet And he sent messengers to gather men from the Israelites. So 32,000 men came. How many men came? A large group of men. 32,000 men came. Then God said to Gideon, "This is too many." So Gideon said, "If anyone is afraid to fight, he may go home." Now, some of the men went home. 22,000 men went home. How many went home? Yes, 22,000 men went home. And 10,000 men stayed. But God said, "You still have too many men. Give them a test." So Gideon decided to give the men a test to see who was brave and strong enough to take part in the fight that they're going to have against their enemies. After the test, only 300 men were left. How many men were left, boys and girls, after the test? Yes, 300 men were left. God said, "I will use these 300 men to save my people." Now, Gideon gave each man a burning torch inside an empty jar. So he gave each man a burning torch inside an empty jar and a trumpet. So look at the picture right here. Do you see these men with their burning torch and their trumpet? What do you think they're getting ready to do? Yes, they're going to attack their enemies, okay? Remember who were their enemies? The Midians who were ruling over the Israelites, okay? So they're going to attack their enemies. When Gideon blew his trumpet, all the Israelite men were supposed to blow theirs, or all the Israelite men blew theirs. So when Gideon blew his trumpet, all the Israelite men blew theirs. They smashed their jars, they held up their torches, and they shouted. So while their enemies were asleep, they went in and they attacked them. The loud noise and bright light frightened the Midianites. So here are the Midianites, these men here in blue. And look at Gideon and his men coming towards them. All they did was hold up their torches and blow their trumpets and smash their jars. The loud noise and the bright light frightened the Midianites. They were so afraid that they started fighting each other and ran away. Boys and girls, Gideon obeyed God, and God helped Gideon. And Gideon helped the Israelites to obey God too. Let me repeat this. Gideon and his men were able to defeat the Midianites because they were so afraid that they started fighting each other and ran away. So boys and girls, because Gideon obeyed God, God helped them. God helped the Israelites Okay. And the Israelites obey God too. What a great story. Let me hope that you did enjoy it, right? So here they are. All of the Israelites, Gideon and his 300 men, attacked and chased away their enemies, the Midianites. Let's review. Who prayed and asked God for help? Yes, the Israelites. The Israelite prayed and asked God for help. They wanted God to help them because the Midianites were ruling over their land. Who did God call to help the people? Yes, he called a man named Gideon. Why do you think he called Gideon, by the way, boys and girls? Why do you think God called Gideon? Yes, Gideon must have been a faithful follower of God while God called him to rule over that group of people. How many men were left in Gideon's army after the test? Yes, after the test, there were 300 men. 300 men helped Gideon to save the people, or to save God's people. Now, what did the men do when Gideon blew his trumpet? What did the men, their enemies, do when Gideon blew his trumpet? They became frightened. They started fighting each other and they ran away. Our last question, who helped the people obey God? Yes, Gideon helped the Israelites to obey God. Let's pray, boys and girls. Dear Lord, we thank you for giving us people who help us to obey you. Father, we ask that you will help us to listen to those people in our lives who help us to learn from you. We thank you for our family. We thank you for our mom and dad, our brothers and sisters. We thank you for all our friends. Father God, help us to continue to obey your words and to do what is right in your sight. Bless us, we pray, in Jesus' name, amen. Okay, boys and girls, let me hope that you enjoy this story, and let me hope that you will share this interesting story about how Gideon helped his people to obey God. Until next time, take care and God bless you.